Hi, this is Anne with SVG Cut File, and today I'm going to show you how to change the text on an SVG file using Cricut Design Space. The file I'm going to work on today is a parking pass SVG, and you might think that you can just import this SVG and just start typing into it where the text currently is, but that is not the case. No SVG file that can come into Cricut Design Space can have typable text. So that means that all fonts that you see in Cricut Design Space, if you're bringing them in with a design, they are changed to shapes. They are no longer live text. And this is a limitation of Cricut Design Space, but there's a workaround. You can just delete the text that's there and then type new text inside Cricut Design Space and have it be whatever you want. So I'll go over that process with you today. All right, let's get started. Okay, so I've opened Cricut Design Space and I'm already signed in. We can see that here. It says, "Welcome, Anne." But if you're not seeing that, you'll need to sign in. So after you do that, come up here to New Project, and then we'll come straight over here to Upload. I'm gonna go ahead and upload image here, and I'll choose Browse to find the file. Now, if you're on a PC, you'll probably see your downloads over here. I'm on a Mac and my downloads are right here. Then we can just kind of navigate to where this parking pass is. Now this file comes with a PNG, SVG, and DXF. This one is the SVG file. It ends in SVG, but if you're not seeing an SVG file, it might be that it's showing up as kind of an internet file, and that is a really common thing with PC computers. So if that's happening to you, I promise it is still an SVG file. It will still work the same way. If you want to see a whole video on that, I'll put one up at the upper right on your screen right now, so you can just click on that and learn about that kind of glitch that PCs do sometimes. So anyway, this is the SVG. It might also look like an internet file, but I'll go ahead and open it. Here it is, and I'll choose Upload. And then I'll click on it right over here. If you've clicked on it, you'll be able to see it right here. And then we'll choose Add to Canvas. So now when I click and drag this, everything moves together. And I want to ungroup this so I can delete certain parts of it. So I'm going to come up here and choose Ungroup. Now when we click and move something, it'll just select that piece. I can hit Delete on my keyboard if I want to. And I can make other changes. So I'm going to go ahead and zoom in. So I'm going to come right down here and click on the plus button. I'll get down here and scroll over. Now these things down here, they're also grouped. So if I click those and move those, they'll all move at once. So I'm going to click it and I'll ungroup these two. Now if I click my logo, I can just delete it. And I'll also delete my phone number. Now I'm going to add my own logo, and this should be in SVG format also. So I'm going to come over here to the upload. I'll upload another image and I'll browse for that one. Now I've saved my logo as an SVG file, and I'm just going to go ahead and open that one. It's a cut image, so it's an SVG file, and we'll upload. I'm going to click on that. You'll see it here also, and then add to canvas. And it's coming in really big, so I'm going to resize it by clicking on this arrow and just pulling that in. Now if it's resizing strangely, make sure that your little lock up here is locked. If it's locked, it'll resize proportionally. I'm gonna make it pretty small and then just position it right where that other logo was. And I'll use my arrow keys to move it over a little bit. I'm gonna zoom in again, and this time I'm going to add my phone number here. So I'll get on my text tool right over here. I'll click that, and then I'll just type 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, 3, 2, 1, 3, 3, 2. I'm going to go ahead and zoom out so I can see that whole thing. And I'll click in there, and then I'm going to hit Command A or Control A. And that will highlight all of the text because I want to resize that text. I want it to be right here's the font size, and I think I'll put this at about 25. We'll see how that looks. And I'll just zoom out. That's looking pretty good. I'll drag it right up here to where it goes. And now we can use this resizer to shrink it down even more. I'm going to double click it to get back into the text, hit Command A or Control A to select it all, and then I'm going to change that text to white. So that's right up here. I'll choose white, and now I'll zoom in again. I'll make it even smaller. Now it looks like these aren't going to show up, but they will. Cricut just puts a little black outline around everything. You can kind of see it right here too. So it's not a problem. It'll still cut the way it should and everything. So that is how to change the details or add text to an SVG file in Cricut Design Space. So now we're ready to make it. All right, I hope this video has helped you. If you're still struggling, feel free to leave a comment in the comment section below. I absolutely answer all of those, so just give me a little bit of time and I will get to you. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.